Expressed on the following sponsored program are strictly those of the host, guests, and callers, and not necessarily those of this station, its staff, management, or sponsors. Welcome to We Are the People with Tracy Marks and Jorge Estamba, who ask you to know what's happening with your student loan. Tracy and Jorge keep a deep look at student loans in this country and the industries that surround it. Every week, We Are the People will bring you new insight into the corporate welfare industry, such as bailouts, and they connect with student loans. The show will highlight on your constitutional rights and how the current system is built to infringe upon them. Join the conversation by visiting our website chat room at wearethepeople.tv. Or call the show at 888-565-1470 and let us hear from you. And now, let's tune in to Tracy and Jorge for this week's discussion.
Good evening. Welcome to another edition of We Are the People, Students for Liberty. This is the edition on November 3rd, 2014. Tracy, if you are with us on a regular basis, Tracy takes his day off to do research for her great work that she does for student loans and all those affected with the student loan crisis that we have in this country. Today is a very special evening for all of us Americans because tomorrow we go to the polls. It's what we call an off-year election, which I don't like the term. Having a marketing degree, I think everything in this country is marketing and how you phrase it, and I think a lot of people get turned away and off by that off-year election. It's a minor opinion that I have because we have a lot of problems getting people out to vote in these off-year elections. They're very important elections. That's why I don't like the word off. There's nothing off about it. In fact, it's on. It's on for the American people. It's on for democracy. This is one of the tools how we keep a democracy going. In recent years, we have really not been doing a very good job as American citizens in turning out to these elections that are non-presidential, how I like to term it, non-presidential elections. But we do elect people to the federal Congress. We do elect people from our state legislature, and we do elect other positions in our state, in our respective states, which is also very important. A lot of people take this for granted. These are the states that we live in. These are our representatives. And remember the word representative, okay? They represent us. They work for us. And so it's very important that we elect those people to represent us and represent our needs. And we as a people have been quite irresponsible, I would say. As time goes on, we become more apathetic. We don't think it's important, especially in, again, in these non-presidential elections. And again, these are the people we elect. They are our employees. This is a constitutional representative democracy. This is something that we have to take responsibility. We have to turn out and vote. We can't take this for granted because, you know, there's an old saying, when you don't utilize something, you're going to lose it. You know, it's like a car. If you don't use it and leave it in a garage, what happens? That motor, when you go to crank it, it's not going to crank. You're going to have problems with it. You're going to have to spend money to get it restarted because we need to utilize things. Democracy is the same way. A lot of countries have confronted problems because people turn to be apathetic. And believe me, we are all human beings. Our politicians see that we do not take interest. They're going to take advantage of it. I was just reading the Nate Silver. Nate Silver is the projections guru, and he does all the statistics, and the guy is the most recognized person who does statistics for trends and so forth. In other words, the science of polling and surveys. And the rating right now is 12% for the approval of Congress. Now, I have seen it lower than that. I have seen it as low as 6%. He just happened to, for this election, say that Congress is still very low, which means that we don't like them. We don't like the people that are in Congress. Well, how can we stop that? I mean, we have awful people in Congress if we are saying that 12%, and again, it's been lower than that. So let's put it at 10% or 12%, however you want it. That means that that body of Congress that we have, which is Senate and U.S. House of Representatives, we don't like those people. I don't like a lot of them either. You know that if you heard his show. I think they're lousy. I think they're corrupt. I think that they're irresponsible. I think they're egotistical. They don't care about us. How can we get these people out? We don't like them. We see it in every poll that comes out. We have to go out to vote. We're a democracy. We don't have coup d'etats in this country. We don't take him out by force and by arms. The military doesn't get involved in our government. This is a pure democracy. We need to go out and vote. In every election, for mayor, for dog catcher, for whatever it is. But when we are electing people who are the ones who take care of the respective state that we live in, I'm not talking only about Florida. As you know, we come from studios in Boca Raton, Florida. Okay? But this country is seen nationally and even internationally. Many people in Venezuela see us, Colombia, because of people that I know in that industry, being in international commerce, who speak English and are very interested. And Americans who live overseas, fortunately, are watching this program. I just spoke to a couple of American friends who live in Guatemala. They went to their embassy. They voted. And, you know, we just have to get in the habit of getting to vote. We make a million and one excuses why we don't vote. We've taken this for granted. And it's very, very dangerous. As I was saying, we cannot afford to lose our democracy. If you give people opportunity, they're going to take advantage of those opportunities we give them. This is a world where, unfortunately, everybody is not good. Okay? This is why we have a screwed up world. That's not an accident. We're the ones who make it what it is. Okay? We're the ones who make wars. We're the ones who make poverty and ignorance. So it's up to us. Us, the people. We are the people. Our Constitution starts with we the people. We have to vote. We have to get these people that we don't like, that we really despise, according to the polls for many years now. This Congress is not working. Our state house is not working in many of the states. Okay? We need to do our job and our responsibility in a democracy. That's what our forefathers thought it out. The greatest minds in the world, the U.S. Constitution, there isn't a better political manifesto or document than our Constitution. We are a model for the world. But we need to keep it up. We can't give up. We can't make excuses. I get tired as an activist. I speak with a lot of people. And I hear all the time, my vote doesn't count. Please, let's not say that. That is being ignorant. Excuse me, but it is being ignorant. Every vote counts in a democracy. You know where it doesn't count? Where I was born, in Cuba. Or in Venezuela, where everything is practically rigged. And in Cuba, it's a one-party system. Or in North Korea. But in our country, our votes do count. But we need to go out and vote. There's a lot of problems in this country. And the only way we're going to resolve them is by getting the right people in the state legislatures and in Washington, D.C., in Congress. For example, we have problems with Social Security. One of the parties, the Republican Party, and as you know, I tell it like it is, whether it's Democrat or Republican. If you want to protect Social Security, You go out there and you vote for that congressperson, okay, that is for Social Security. We pay for that. That's not a given. That is not welfare like a lot of these jerks in the Congress say. I paid into that. I expect to get paid when I retire some years from now. My mother and every single one of your parents and grandparents and uncles, they paid into that. So we need to put those people who represent us that will protect our Social Security that is in jeopardy. Medicare, that's another issue. We need to put the people who will take care of us in our health, and do not think that all these things are Ponzi schemes or all these ridiculous things that we listen to, and some of us get fooled into that, and we don't go out to vote. Those are the people that I believe we need to get out. These are basic things that we, the people, are entitled to. They're not freebies, folks. We pay for these things out of our taxes, and they want to take it away from us? Don't put these people back in Congress. Take them out. Send them a message that we're not going to allow this anymore. But if we stay in our couch and we don't go and we can't stand in line for 2 or 3 hours, maybe 5 hours, because of all the dirty tricks that some of the politicians pull in some states, including our great state of Florida, which is called voter suppression, to call every trick in the book, let that be a challenge to you. Don't let them take our vote away. Don't fall into their tricks. Make that, get pissed off and say, I'm not going to take that. I'm going to show you that I, as an American, I am going to the voting polls and I'm going to stand in line 5 or 6 hours under 90 degree temperatures. I'm going to show you, Mr. Big Shot, that I am an American, that I will fight for democracy, and I will not allow you to take that given right that I have to vote. We have to be strong. We cannot be weak. We have to show them that they are our employees. It's not the other way around. We elect them. That's the way it was made out by our forefathers. Again, the greatest minds that ever founded a country. And there's a lot of great countries in the world. But this is definitely one that we had geniuses founding our country. We can't let anybody take away our rights. We work later on to make sure that we get voter suppression, but we have to work for it as people. Now, tomorrow, many of you have not voted. I urge you, please, go out and vote. I don't care whether you vote Republican or Democrat or whatever. Go out to vote. I just don't want to see this great exercise of voting being diminished every year and falling to more tricks. This is how we lose things. We get into bad habits. We create bad things. Don't let a monster be created. It's growing. Don't let things get out of hand and say later on, I wish I would have. If you don't like somebody, get them out. That's what elections are all about. There's amendments. There are things about the environment. There's things about schools. There's many things around the country in different states that are for us to decide. But getting 20 and 25% like we do here in South Florida, that's horrible. That's sickening. 30%, 35%, it's sickening. Western Europe, it's 60, 70, 80%. Yes, some of the countries have mandatory voting. Maybe we should do that. Maybe we should have mandatory voting. Because we certainly are doing a lousy job of doing it voluntarily. Year after year, in the non-presidential elections, we don't perform our rights. We have problems with the environment. Some people say that there is no global warming, that there is no problem with the environment. Well, 98% of the scientists in the world who are environmentalists and climatologists, 98% say there is a problem. 97% of the ones in the United States say there is a problem. 100% of the American National Academy of Science say there is a problem. Our great state of Florida and South Florida is in danger, according to scientists. These are not radicals. These are not hippies. These are people, learned people, who spent years and years studying this. And because some of these churches say that they're not scientists, but then they do make an opinion that this is a bunch of BS from these scientists, that's double talk. Right off the bat, that's a lie. And you know why? Because they don't want the large corporation to spend any money in making any modifications. They want it as it is. Corporate welfare. A lot of people are getting very, very upset at that. We can take out the people who are bringing corporate welfare. All 25% of corporations don't pay taxes. I know a lot of you are really upset at that. In the polls, in the news, the people I speak to, let's get the people out who are pro-corporation and against the middle class. We are deteriorating. We can do it. Again, I don't care what party you're for. I'm a Democratic. I belong to the Democratic Party. I don't vote straight ticket. But you know what? The important thing is to get there. You vote for whatever party you want. I'm telling you and reminding you the things that are important to the majority of us Americans. Social Security, health, education, something that we strive and we make it a point. It's called Students for Liberty. We are the people, Students for Liberty. These loans, a lot of these Congress people do not give us a break for all the people that have these student loans. Let's get these people out. I know most of you who have children and a lot of students and people who have been affected by this are very upset about it. Go out to vote. Get these people out who don't want to help you, who rather help the corporations and give them breaks and tax breaks. You're not getting any tax breaks. On the contrary, you can't even declare bankruptcy. And I say you because I've never had that problem, thank God, when I went to college. But we can do something about it. That's my message. The message is very simple, folks. We do have problems. We're not in agreement with Congress in general in this country, in this state. We have a governor, and yes, I'm going to tell it like it is. That doesn't mean I'm biased, but we have a governor who rejected $51 billion, that's with B as in boy, or B as in bad, for we the people. He took that away from us. Now, I don't know about you, but I don't want anybody running a state, and that is Rick Scott. And this is my opinion, and I'm trying to challenge you to vote. If you like Rick Scott, go out and keep him. I can't be any more honest. If you think that's right, go ahead. Make your opinion. You're with that, okay? You're being screwed. 1.2 million people are being screwed of getting health in this state. If you're with that, go ahead. Vote Rick Scott. Vote with your heart. If you're not, if you're against that, and you're against a guy who was fined $1.7 billion for the fraud he committed with his clinic, then vote, get motivated, and get him out of office. Again, if you're for that, hey, this is a free democracy. You can like whoever you want. Go ahead and vote. But vote. I can't be any more clear. I can't be any more honest. I'm saying you like Rick Scott. Go ahead. Vote. Go out and vote. As you can see, this is not politically generated. I'm putting my opinions of the points I think are important. I'm criticizing a person or persons who I think are not conducive to we the people, the 98% of the people. But I'm being very honest with you. I'm very afraid that we Americans are going to lose this because I don't trust politicians. I don't trust Democrats. I don't trust Republicans. I don't trust any of them. If you want me to be honest with you, which I always am, I try to choose the person who's going to try and represent me the best. And I look and I do my homework and I try to choose that person who will represent me to the best of his ability. Next time around, he didn't do a good job, he's out. That's what democracy is all about. And we participate in town hall meetings and we write to them and we write petitions. We go on moveon.org and tell them what we don't like. That is democracy. But now we get back to point that is the integral part of this program. Elections. Please do not ever think that your vote doesn't count. Please don't say that you're not going to change anything. We can always change things in a democracy if we want to make changes. If we sit around, if we don't go out to vote, and you say, well, why the heck is Jorge, you know, making such a big deal? There's only one day left. Because there's a tremendous amount of people that leave it to the last day, and that's fine. There's nothing wrong with that. I've done it a million and one things. I didn't do it this year. I thought I'd do it earlier and avoid standing in line. And those are the options you have. We have a lot of options, folks. We can't make excuses. Early voting, ballots, I mean, left and right. The media publicizes it. You get things in the mail, email. We do not have any excuses. I'm not going to blame the politicians for this. It's us. It's up to us. It's our responsibility. Go out and vote. I don't know, except, of course, those people that listen to me internationally and listen to this program internationally. Well, as a matter of fact, I'm wrong. You can go out to vote also. In the embassies or the polling places that are situated overseas, you also need to vote. Of course, the majority of our listeners and viewers are here in the States. And we have people from all over the United States listening. This is not only for Florida. This, I'm addressing this to all of us. All of us who live in this great country. Let's keep it a great country. Let's not take any chances of not participating in this great, great system that we have. Politicians, you know what they love? For the low turnouts. Because the people who really support these candidates, they're very faithful and they'll go out. So what does that mean? It means that these guys that have been there forever, that we criticize every day, they're going to stay in power. And they were voted in democratically, legitimately. We can't complain. We can't come Wednesday morning and say, oh, that guy's back again? Geez, been there forever. Well, you didn't do a goddamn thing. I'm sorry to say that. Then you don't have any right to say anything, realistically. Go out to vote. Get that guy out of there if you're sick of him. And if you like him, keep him in. But don't let that minority that always, you know, the fanatics with these guys, there's nothing wrong with that. But the fanatics that keep these guys in forever, they're the ones who always go out to vote. And they just keep getting reelected and reelected. And then we complain. And this is, what do we get from that? A rating of less than 12. Well, let's round it off to what Nate Silver just published. 12% of the American people approve of our Congress. That means we've done I mean, they're the first ones that have done a horrible job. That in itself, there's no excuse for that. But I'm challenging you to realize that we have a horrible Congress. We the people are saying that. Now we the people can do something about it. Folks, it's up to us. We've got a lot of problems that can be solved. This is a great country. This is a great nation. We got the greatest political manifesto ever put in the hands of man. Let's take advantage of it. Let's really churn out. Let's show the politicians that we care about our country and that we won't allow them to get away with all the crap that they're getting away with. They're stepping on us. Education, Social Security, healthcare, corporate welfare, minimum wage. I almost forgot about that one. It affects 25 million people in this country. That's 27% of the workforce. Maybe 30 million. I don't remember exactly, but I know it's 27% is being affected by that. You know who is for minimum wage increase, and you know who's not. You're the one who's getting killed. We are the one that's getting killed. 27% of us. How about equal pay? How about women? You're a second-class citizen. Second-class citizen, according to many of the congresspeople. Go out to vote. So here we have it. Students, people who have received student loans, people who need Social Security and will fight for Social Security because we pay for that, whether you're retired or not. If you're in your 40s, 50s, it doesn't matter the age, Social Security, health, low minimum, or minimum wage, fair living wage. There's so many things that this country has been affected, the middle class deteriorating. We can change that. We can improve it, folks. It's up to us. I've had a full 28 minutes of this program, no commercials, because this is how important it is. It's for not for me, it's not for a few, it's for 315 million Americans who need to get this country back on track. We can do it. We are Americans. We've always resolved our problems in a democratic manner, but we need to go out and vote. Please, tomorrow, go out and vote. No excuses. You like the guy, keep him in office. You don't like him, don't vote for him. But vote. This is how we will keep our democracy going, and this is how we will remain a great country. I hope this program was worthwhile. I'm trying to challenge you people. I had to challenge myself some years ago because we are human beings. I'm not perfect. I was there also at one time, but I learned my lesson. That's why I'm an activist now. To activate, to get people involved, to get you to realize that we the people are the ones that run this country in a democratic manner. We'll see you tomorrow at the polls. Do some research at the last moment. Look over whatever you need to do. Make the right choice. And let's keep this democracy going. We'll see you next week. Peace. Speeding away. Thought she was James Dean for a day. Then I guess she had to crash. Valium would have helped that best. CPA for the People provides CPA services and business consulting for innovative creators. Collaborative, personal, affordable. We specialize in tax consulting, business consulting, financial statement compilation, and personal finance. For more information, please go to www.cpaforthepeople.com or call at area code 6-